Concerts, fan meets, and special events are all appropriate places where you have the opportunity to see and possibly be given the chance to meet your favorite idol alongside other fans that share the same love for them. What happens if you can't make it to one of these for any reason, or you simply cannot fathom any other person meeting or being with them besides you? Find out what the extreme measures these so-called fans took to meet and be with their favorite idols by any means necessary. Hi everyone, and welcome back to Midnight Theories. And if you're new here, welcome to Midnight Theories. Forget everything you thought you knew about K-pop. Welcome to your new home for all K-pop related theories, urban legends, and news. Enjoy your stay, consider dropping a like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell to be notified when I release a new video. For those of you who may not be familiar with the term, according to Wikipedia, Sasaeng is an obsessive fan who stalks or engages in other behavior constituting an invasion of privacy of a Korean idol or other public figure. The term Sasaeng comes from the Korean word sa, meaning private, and saeng, meaning life, in reference to the fan's intrusion into celebrities' private lives. It's unfortunate to say that there have been well over hundreds of cases of Sasaeng attacks, ranging from social media hackings, break-ins, car chases, to even worse, poisoning. And to be completely honest, the list goes on. Today, we'll be going over the attempted, fake, and successful kidnappings of some of the most popular idols in the industry. A few well-known Sasaeng cases were the attempted and thankfully unsuccessful EXO and Taeyeon kidnapping pranks. EXO, who have been targeted in several Sasaeng attacks, were almost taken by a group of fans who came up with a bait-and-switch plan that almost worked. After a long day of busy schedules, the boys were done with work and ready to head home. There was a van parked nearby the building that looked very similar to the one EXO would use. As they were heading right to the van, their manager felt like something was off and had a strange suspicion that something was wrong. He stopped the boys from entering and asked them to go back inside the building. The manager was right to listen to his instincts. A group of Sasaengs rented a van that looked identical to theirs in hopes that the boys would get in the vehicle. Sasaengs are bold with their behavior, trying to get idols to remember them by any means necessary. In 2011, at the Angel Price Music Festival, Girls' Generation were on stage performing when a strange man approached the stage and dragged Taeyeon in the middle of their performance. Her member Sunny noticed that Taeyeon's hands were no longer on her shoulder and turned around. In a split second, she was able to analyze the situation and follow the pair. The MC sprung in action and tried to pull him away from Taeyeon, and the other two securities rushed in and pulled the strange man away. As soon as the song was over, her members rushed to her side and tried to figure out what was going on. The Korean media outlet praised Oh Jung-tae as a hero for stopping the incident. He said, "I didn't really control the situation at all. The security guards are the ones who controlled the situation and stopped the fan. All I did was try to remove his hand from Taeyeon. I believe the way this fan expressed his love for SNSD was different, and I hope he will continue to love SNSD in a better way." The mystery man's identity was later confirmed to be an ordinary university student. In a phone interview, the event organizer revealed, "After interrogating the suspect, it was revealed he was a common university student. Because he admitted his wrong, a police investigation was not filed. He's still young, and it was taken into account that he has studies and academic responsibilities." After seeing that Taeyeon did not incur serious injuries, SM Entertainment decided not to take legal action, and the man is now pondering about his wrongful actions at home. Unlike what fans are thinking, the man did not have a mental illness. He was just an avid fan of Taeyeon's. He admitted his wrong and now realizes the mistake he made. The event organizer issued an official apology and gave the buyers a full refund. I covered these next two stories in my Worst Pranks in K-pop series. Although these situations were not real, the feelings and thoughts going through these idols' heads were all too real. On their first trip to America as a group, BTS were on a program called American Hustle Life in 2014. The show was about the members carrying out different missions to, quote, experience true hip-hop culture. When the boys landed at the airport, they were picked up by staff and enjoyed an eventful day of exploring before the unexpected happened. On their ride to their place of stay, the manager announced that he needed to finish signing some documents due to some visa issues and they would be making a stop. The manager left the van unattended and the boys were ambushed by some unwelcome guests. Three unknown men hopped in the van and drove off to an unknown location. the boys were terrorized and humiliated by these men. You could see and feel the fear and desperation in these young boys' eyes. The boys were informed by a video that this was all part of the show, and on this trip, they would be going through extensive training. After the video was over, the three men headed out and told them,
"We're gonna be back here tomorrow, so y'all can just stay here. Peace!
We'll be watching you."
The fans were divided. One half saw it as just a part of the show and laughed along. The other half were appalled that the show would even pull a prank like that, and not to mention how they portrayed the stereotypical image of a black man. This next kidnapping prank I covered in two of my previous videos, so to get the full details, you can head over to one of those videos after this. But to quickly summarize, Simon was a trainee at the time of this prank for a hidden camera show. The idol was kidnapped by a few men who threatened and blindfolded him. He was in the car for 2 hours as they drove to their destination. There in the building, they tied him up with rope and tape until an actress, who portrayed to be assassin, terrorized him, which caused him emotional distress and made him comply with her every request. Pranks are supposed to be funny and lighthearted. They should never cause harm or leave emotional damage. Yvonne is a first-generation solo singer who gained popularity in the 90s. She was an actress, radio DJ, and an MC for many programs. In 2020, Yvonne was a guest on Kim Soo Mi's Did You Eat? During the program, she revealed the shocking details of her kidnapping in the 90s. After a long, exhausting day of filming, she was ready to head back home. Her manager left her unattended to heat up the car because there was only 20 minutes left of filming. As she headed down the stairs, she blacked out. The next morning, she woke up in an unfamiliar room. As she tried to collect herself, she heard two voices in the distance. The next day, when I opened my eyes, I realized it wasn't my room. I heard someone from outside my room ask, "Why did you bring her here and cause this mess?" Then I realized that I had been kidnapped and that he may not want to harm me. I went outside the room and asked why they kidnapped me. My kidnapper told me that his brother was a huge fan, so he went overboard for him. Realizing he was a fan, I asked him to show me around their neighborhood. They agreed and proceeded to show her around and even had a meal together. The next day, they drove her back home. She was gifted a sports car as a proposal gift after the kidnapping, but she declined several times, and it ended there. On an episode of Radio Star, Anne, a member of VIX, shared an interesting story about one of the group's airport trips. On their way home from their trip to Kazakhstan, VIX and their manager were in a van heading to the airport. Their manager got off the van first, and the door shut right behind him, and the van sped off. The members were a little bit confused, but thought there was some miscommunication. We asked where we were going, and the bus driver told us that because checking in was going to take a while, they were taking us to the airport lounge first. The members decided to rest and nap the rest of the ride. While this was going on, the manager was in full panic mode and tried to run after the van. They arrived at the lounge, and they were accommodated like royalty. Their manager eventually caught up to them and he was denied access into the lounge. The guard told us our manager couldn't come in because only distinguished guests were allowed. Not too long after, a young girl walked in. She was a high school student, and get this, the daughter of the president of Kazakhstan, who is commonly referred to as the country's princess. The whole scheme was just a way for her to get a private meet and greet with the boys. Some of you might recognize this next person if you watch K-dramas recently. But before that, Kwon Nara was a member of girl group Hello Venus. On an episode of Happy Together, she revealed that she was almost abducted during her training years. After a long, exhausting night of training, she asked her father if he could pick her up. She waited outside by the nearest bus stop when a strange vehicle approached her. Before she knew it, a man darted her way and was trying to drag her into the van. She started to scream in fear, but there was no one in sight. Right until a car honked and she realized it was her dad. The mysterious man let go of her at that moment and drove off. Sadly, this was not the only time Nara felt her life was in danger. Back when she was a high school student, she would take the same route home. One day, she was heading home while she still had her earphones in. When she noticed someone was following behind her, she took one of the earphones out and could hear footsteps behind her. She took the other earphone out and started to walk slowly, trying not to cause suspicion. When she turned around, she saw a man with a hat. They made eye contact, and it probably surprised him that she noticed him, and he walked the other way. Brave Reporters was a show where reporters and journalists from a variety of backgrounds reveal the hidden truths behind various cases, from huge political scandals to mysterious cases that are not well known to the public. On an episode of Brave Reporters, many industry insiders came forward about an unnamed disbanded girl group and their abusive producer. The popular female producer was hired to make a song for the company's new rookie girl group that was set to debut. The company was rather small, but the group was already pretty popular. And not to mention that one of the members was a former beauty pageant contestant who was also skilled in singing and dancing. The producer tried to charm the members by constantly complimenting them and bringing them snacks. When the group finally debuted, their schedule was soon packed with fans and grew a pretty solid fan base. The group had a packed schedule filled with photo shoots, events, and program appearances. One day, the group expected to appear on a show, yet they'd never arrived. The CEO went to the dorms to locate the girls and manager, but they were nowhere in sight. He continuously called them, but to no avail. The staff from the program were growing annoyed by the rookie group's unprofessional late behavior and kept asking the CEO where the group was. Due to the pressure he felt he was under, he lied and told the production staff that the group was involved in an accident. The girls were missing for days and no one had heard from them. The company canceled several upcoming events to figure out what had happened to the girls. Word got around that the company was canceling their schedules left and right. This was unusual behavior for a company to keep canceling plans, and the company lost a lot of credibility. Several days had passed, and the CEO finally got in contact with one of the members. She called him asking him to come where they were. The members' voices were described as weak and on the verge of death. The CEO obtained the location and found the girls. The girls were described to look very weak and reduced to bones. They also had an unpleasant smell due to the conditions they faced those days. The girls confided in their CEO and told him that their female producer invited them to visit before their initial broadcast. The manager drove the members to the producer's home, and that is when they saw her gripping a baseball bat. The producer allegedly asked the manager if he wanted to team up, and she would promote him if he stayed in silence. The producer continued to make threats at the girls, threatening to hit them with a baseball bat if they did not follow orders. She tried to make them sign a contract with a different company. The girls hesitated at first, but that was when the producer allegedly began to beat them with the bat. Even after the beating, the members still refused to sign, so the producer locked them in a room and took away their cell phones. After finally being released from the nightmare of their experience, they explained to the CEO that they would leave the entertainment industry and retire as idols due to the traumatizing experience. There have been many suspicions that the group could have been milked, but a lot of the information doesn't align if you do further research, and most of the members are still active in the entertainment industry. There's also speculations that it could have been a three-member girl group, Perfume, not to be confused with the ever-so-popular J-pop girl group, Perfume. But once again, I'd like to repeat that these are all speculations and rumors, and I highly recommend you do your own research. One of the major issues that lie with netizens is the heinous crime was never reported to authorities. People fear that since the producer was never reprimanded for her actions, that she could still be working in the industry to this day. Many countries all over the world have implemented anti-stalking laws, but in South Korea, there was no special law that prevented or penalized stalking celebrities. That held true until some more serious crimes started to be committed and new clauses were added to protect celebrities. What are your thoughts on these sasaengs? Are they just overzealous fans, or is their obsessive love for their idols taken way to the extreme? Let me know all your thoughts and comments down below. And as always, thank you for watching and enjoy your stay.
Magic.